everyone, welcome back to Encounter Encouragement. Last time, I talked about how to de-escalate a problem before it becomes a problem. Today, we're going to continue on that theme. However, we're starting at a different point. We're starting at when there is a problem, what do you do? I came across a situation this weekend where I asked someone for help, and in helping me, this person decided to help themselves in a way that was completely inappropriate. Now, at the moment, for those of you who remember the old Ma Bell telephone system, I wanted to reach out and touch someone, and it wasn't going to be pleasant if I did. However, I realized that in this situation, that would not be a completely appropriate reaction. And the point is, I don't want to be reactionary to a situation. I want to be able to have a well thought out response to any given situation instead of just reacting with no thought put into my actions. Because usually that can escalate a situation to a point where there may be no return. And in addition, it may be very detrimental to one or both parties. So, what I did at the moment was I deflected. I ended the situation as quickly as I could. And I went about my business and spent the rest of the weekend up through now trying to figure out what is my response going to be regarding this situation. The Bible talks about if you have a problem with a brother, then you take it straight to that brother and hopefully you explain your situation, and if they have wronged you, they will apologize and repent and you offer them forgiveness and you've won your brother over. If they do not apologize, repent, or admit their wrongdoing, then you bring a couple members of the church with you to confront the situation. And you continue on moving up the steps until you have a final resolution. I've decided that this is the way that I am going to handle this situation so that I am not immediately being reactionary to ruin potentially both parties' situation. It could be very detrimental for both this other person and myself. So I don't want to go to the top when I can go to the source first. I might need to go to the top if the behavior doesn't change. However, for now, I'm going to take one step at a time. I plan on going to this person to say, here's what happened. I know that you know what happened was inappropriate. This behavior is not okay. It will not be tolerated. And if it happens again, you will be moving up that ladder to more and more and more appropriate action, shall we say? In the meantime, I'm going to give this person the opportunity to apologize, to admit they were wrong, and to prove or to say that they will not do it again. Because if it happens again to me or somebody else, this inappropriate behavior will not be tolerated. And that's the bottom line. I don't have to be reactionary. I don't have to scream. I don't have to shout. I don't have to let everybody in the world know, within hearing distance, what happened. I need to look that person straight in the eye and say, this is what happened. You and I both know it. Now let's put an end to it right now. And this is one way that you can step back, as an example, step back, take a minute at the immediate time, deflect, get out of the situation, remove yourself from it, and take time to think, to weigh the possibilities, to see what could happen, and to then appropriately choose a course of action. Instead of reacting, choose your response. When you react to a situation without thinking, you are not choosing a response. You are just insanely going off the deep end for the situation, and it may be way more than what's called for. Therefore, slow down, remove yourself from the situation, take some time to go through the alternatives of what could or could not happen, go to that person directly, give them an opportunity to state their case, to apologize, to explain why they think they weren't wrong, or to say why they were. Give them that opportunity, because that escalation immediately by being reactionary is not going to make the situation any better. It increases their level of frustration and defense, when in reality, you just need to have a conversation with the person to go over the situation and what's going to happen in the future. So, what situations have you been in where you have been reactionary and overreacted immediately? Or what situations have you done what I'm explaining? Step back, taken time, thought it through, and responded as opposed to reacted. I hope that maybe this will give you some insight into a better way to handle a situation that may be uncomfortable or just downright wrong. In either case, I am very much tepid about going and having to take and handle this conversation, but I'm also excited for the fact that I know I'm doing the right thing. I know that I'm going to get a positive response, and that I believe I won't have to take it any farther. So, until next time, I hope that you are totally blessed and that you have a fabulous rest of the week. Thanks, everyone.